Is this lens any good? What is good, YouTube? It's That One Camera Guy, back at again with another video for you. Today we're going to be taking a look at an APS-C manual focus prime lens for E-mount designed by Seven Artisans. It's a 25mm lens with a it's an aperture of f1.8. Again, stressing that it is a manual focus prime lens. Now, when you do a 35mm equivalency, it's going to be roughly 37.5mm, which is near 35mm. I absolutely love the 35mm focal length on a full frame system, and that's the reason why this lens appealed to me for folks who happen to have like an A6000 or A6000 series body. So what makes this interesting? As of right now, there are really no super cost-effective manual focus prime lenses at this particular focal length and aperture. Now, there are some exceptions coming around soon, which is like the Sigma 16mm f1.4, which is an autofocus lens. And there's also the 25mm f2 bodice lens, but that's an autofocus lens and full frame. And by the way, a lot more expensive than this lens. So what really makes this exciting is that this is only $70. I know some of you are gonna say that you could just go ahead and pick up a manual focus prime lens from the yesteryears, and you absolutely can. And I would recommend you leave some suggestions in the comments below for people that are looking for manual focus prime lenses. This just interests me because it's already E-mount and I don't have to add any adapters. So it just plugs in and works straight away. Now, in terms of the actual build of this lens, the lens, although compact, does have a little bit of heft to it, but not much. It's not super heavy, but it does feel a little dense. You can feel a little bit of metal as well as plastic in the actual build of it. So it's good. I'm not saying it's amazingly great, but it's good, the build. In terms of the actual focus ring, I find that they're mostly smooth, especially the focus one. At first, it kind of had a weird, tiny kind of grind to it, almost like there was sand. But after using it a little bit more, that kind of went away completely. So now when I turn it slowly, I don't have that issue. The aperture ring itself is de-clicked. Well, that's what it is. There's no clicks to the actual aperture ring. So those of you that do video might really enjoy that. And overall, really smooth. Not any issues with that at all. I would say that the rings are both dampened very well, so that way you won't knock them and change the settings very easily on these particular lens. Now, using the lens is quite enjoyable, apart from the autofocus lenses that I typically use, but slowing down and shooting with a prime lens is actually quite enjoyable if you're taking your time. So something I want to note with this particular lens, usually when I'm shooting with prime lenses, I typically don't have any issues, especially when I have like focus peaking enabled or I'm using the EVF, for example. But for whatever reason, this one, sometimes my confidence kind of takes a dip. In other words, sometimes I'll look and it seems like it's in focus, I'll take the photo, and then when I bring it into the computer later, it's not in focus. So it didn't happen too often, but I would highly recommend that you use the focus magnifier option in your camera to make sure you're getting tack sharp images, or when we get to the image quality, you'll know what I mean, the sharpest images that you can get. Okay, that's my recommendation. All right, so now we're gonna go ahead and jump into the image quality section. I'm gonna go ahead and dive into my tutorial mode here. So let's go ahead and take a look. All right, so right now we're looking at the vignette portions. As far as the setup, we have f1.8 here. Next, we have f2, if it'll load. And then we have f2.8, f4, f5.6, f8, and f16. Now, in terms of vignette, it looks to kind of clear up. As soon as you get to around f5.6, it's mostly gone. But there's still hints of the vignette. But at f1.8, the vignette on the lens is very heavy, so keep that in mind. Let's go ahead and jump into the image a little bit and check sharpness in this example. Sharpness-wise, it looks okay to me. I'm actually at 2:1. Let me go to 1:1. It looks fine. But when you go to the edges of the actual image, you'll notice that it's very, very blurry on the edges here. So not very sharp on the corners. So keep that in mind as far as this lens is concerned. The center area is going to be kind of your sweet spot. Let's go ahead and jump to f2.8, which things kind of get a little bit better for the lens. Yeah, it tends to sharpen up a little bit more. The edges are still somewhat blurry. I don't think that clears up until close to like f8 of the lens. And so this is f8 example, and it's gotten a bit better than when we first started. So let's go ahead and do a quick comparison here. Okay, so we're taking a look at f1.8 on the left and f8 on the right. You can see here that the corner sharpness does improve, but it's still blurry at the very edges, and the same kind of story on both sides. It does improve by f8. F5.6 is a little bit better, but that's just the situation with this particular lens. Now let's go ahead and jump over to some text examples and take a look at this. So I'm going to go ahead and do some comparisons. I'm just going to jump to kind of the major portions here. So this is F1.8 on the left, F2.8 on the right. Let's go ahead and jump in there. I'm going to go to 2:1. You'll notice that at F2.8, it does improve. So F2.8 is on the right-hand side, F1.8 is on the left-hand side. All right, so now we have F1.8 on the left and then F4 on the right-hand side, and it gets even better. And by F5.6, it tends to be pretty darn good. So let's go ahead and compare F4 to F5.6. I have F4 on the left and F5.6 on the right. It does get a little bit sharper, and that's pretty much where it kind of caps out. So F5.6 appears to be the point at which this lens seems to do really darn well in the center portion of the actual lens. Again, I just want to stress to you that I'm really not the de facto lens expert. This is just kind of my pseudo testing and just kind of get a general feel for the actual lens and the results. Now, unfortunately, I didn't really test the lens out too much with video. I can tell you that the footage that's being recorded me of right now is with the 7 Artisans lens. I'm using the A9, using crop mode, and I'm recording straight into a capture card into my computer. I'm shooting at f1.8, and this is what the video quality looks like right now. You can definitely notice the heavy vignettes on the edges, just like we saw with the images, unless that's just the lighting in my room, but this is exactly what it looks like. Conclusion. So who is this lens for? I think this lens is a really good one if you're just starting out, you've got an A6000 or mirrorless body, and you just want to go in and snap some photos, and you want to create some of that shallow depth of field like you saw in the examples. It's fairly wide on this lens, it's fairly wide on this body, and you know what, it's $70, it's not going to break the bank for most of you, compared to a lens that's $400, $500. It will be typical to learn if you're not used to manual focus prime lenses, but I do have a video you can check out over here that shows you how to use and operate a manual focus lens. There is some optical deficiencies. There is barrel distortion on this lens, so you're going to kind of see a bulge in the middle towards the center of it. So make sure you look at some more examples online, and hopefully my images can kind of give you an idea of what this lens is capable of doing. Don't forget you're going to add some sharpening to your actual images because the images wide open are a bit soft. And with that said, if you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe, and check out my other content. And with that said, I'm your host, Dalwin Camera Guy, and I'll catch you on the next video. Bye.